Welcome to CLA 215, Section 7, The Peer Group. Introduction. In this study section, we shall discuss the peer group as an agent of socialization. We shall also examine the characteristics of peer group and how members of the peer group use communication. Learning outcome. When you have studied this session, you should be able to 1. Define and point out the characteristics of the peer group, and 2. Show how the peer group use communication. The peer group, meaning and characteristics. If the family exercises the strongest influence upon the child, his age mates or peers exert the second strongest influence. In fact, there are strong suggestions that in the modern world, where the family members are together only rarely, both parents work, and the child moves from school classroom to school lesson and to another lesson after school, that the peers exert more influence than the parents. The child's peers become increasingly important to him as he moves away from his parents towards independence. From his peers, he learns many things he needs to know in order to become an adult. His movement away from parents to peers is not always easy, and indeed it is frequently marked by strain and tension for both the child and the parent. The peer group is unique in some ways. Let us discuss these unique characteristics of the peer group. Unlike the family, the peer group runs on a fairly egalitarian and equalitarian basis. A peer group is a group of equals. Of course, there is usually an informal leader or a set of decision makers, but the hierarchical structure which obtains in the family is always not there. Another characteristic of the peer group is that it encourages and supports breakaway from parental constraints. The group usually encourages the child to establish his own independent identity. In most cases, the peer group often stands against the position of the family. Third, the peer group is not an established institution, unlike the family. Roles of members of a peer group are less well defined and may change frequently. Again, unlike in the family, where roles are more or less consistent, children change membership of the peer group as they go through life, but they hardly change their membership of the family and may belong to more groups than one at a time. A child at one time may be a member of the youth organization in the neighborhood, a football team, a football team's fans club, and a church or mosque youth group. In each of these groups, the child has a certain status and is expected to behave in a certain way. The peer group offers the child the chance not only to break away, but also to take responsibilities for his actions and inactions. Groups assign and saddle members with duties and responsibility they would otherwise not have been saddled with in a different context. Most discussions of peer groups always cast them in antagonistic, anti-establishmentarian, rebellious, and negative light. Almost all the time, they are seen as polluting and destroying the child with evil values. This is not true in all cases. Peer groups have been valuable sources of inspiration, community service, education, and innovation in many societies. Among the Igbo people, the age grade system is meant to help the child develop along with his peers into a useful and valuable member of the society. Peer groups embark on community service of various forms. Peer groups have also been an avenue in the fight against HIV/AIDS in the developing world through the means of peer education. The peer group influences and is influenced by communication and communication media more than we think. For example, as Hartley 1999 rightly observed, teenage gangs often develop strong norms for behaving and communicating among themselves. We begin acquiring a language or languages in the family, but soon as we move to school, we begin to get influenced by the language of the peer group. We are in 2001, as described the peer group as a social organ that has an important influence on adolescent achievement, beliefs, and behaviors. Peer groups influence a person's communication in a number of ways. First, the peer group offers the child an opportunity to discuss issues and topics forbidden by the parents. Top on such list of forbidden topics is sex. Naturally, people, especially young individuals, are always attracted to and affiliated with others that share similar attributes or do similar things. This tendency of group attraction is a social dynamic, otherwise referred to as homophilia. Ryan 2001. Depending on how strict parents are, topics such as smoking, drug use, drinking, and gambling, conversion to a different religion, or marrying someone from a different religion or culture are regarded as sensitive issues that children should not be allowed to discuss. Therefore, the peers come together based on issues of common interest and exercise the freedom of expression that the home may not allow. Second, the peer group influences a person's language use. Slang expressions are common among peer groups and are not usually used or encouraged by most families. Words and expressions considered are obscene and unclean by families are also used freely in many peer groups. We want to note that many peer groups prohibit such words as well. All groups operate by their own rules. Besides, peer group as an agent of socialization serves as the platform for inculcation of social norms, cultural values, and gender awareness among the youth. Tetroth 2006, based on the findings of a study among Algerian youth in France, shares a similar view as she submits that peer groups not only contribute to transgressive communicative practices in early adolescence, but also serve as a vehicle for adopting more conservative gender and cultural values at the onset of adulthood. Peer groups influence the choice of media products a person makes. The peer group influences all magazines that the young person reads, the television programs he watches, the videos he borrows and watches. Very often, a member of the group watches something and recommends it to others. It may, however, be less direct than that. In some cases, a group has developed a taste, and members consume every available media product that are consistent with or promote their taste. For instance, members of a specific football fans club would not wait until they are told to buy a wristband that carries the name of their football team. The peer group also influences a person's non-verbal cues, the shape and size of the clothing a person wears, that is, miniskirts, sagged trousers, makeups, etc. The non-verbal gestures he exhibits while talking, how he walks, etc. are influenced often by the peer group. Everyone wants to be accepted by his group and will do what others in the group do in order to get acceptance. Study session summary. As we have discussed in this study session, the peer group is a group of people who are of about the same age bracket and move together as a social unit. The peer group exerts great influence on the child because, apart from the family, the child's nearest constituency is his peer group. The peer group has a structure that is anchored on egalitarian principle. It encourages breakaway from parental constraints. Its role distribution is fluid, that is, flexible undefined because it is not an established institution. Membership of the peer group is neither sacrosanct nor permanent, and it encourages members to take responsibility for their actions. Besides, the peer group uses communication in some peculiar ways. For instance, the mode of communication among the peers allow members to discuss some issues or topics forbidden by parents, and among others, they use slang expressions as part of their communication mode. End of study session 7. Thanks for listening.